Chip, Caroline, this is how it's gonna go down. Mrs. Lloyd will be down here any minute.
Yeah, you see, she's got this fancy ladies coming to visit. You know, the ones from the Ladies Society.
So when she gets here, Chip, you need to start crying, see? And she's gonna go, why, Chip, whatever is the matter.
And you're gonna sniff and snuff and take your little hanky out of pocket and say in your status voice, oh, Miss Lloyd, I'm just a poor boy without a home.
And Caroline, this is where you come in.
Yeah, you're gonna say in your sweetest voice, oh, Miss Lloyd, I think I know who makes you happy. And she'll say, really? And what would that be, Caroline?
And you'll go, he's been ever so sad lately, and I think what made him happy is that one of those fancy ladies could buy us kids at the orphanage a wheat system for Christmas.
But I don't even know what a wheat system is. It's a wheat system, Chip, and you don't need to know what it is, because once again, you'll never chance play anyways.
Yeah, so just say what we tell you to, and maybe we'll let you play a wheat. A game on the Wii where none of those old biddies buy us one.
It's not nice to call them these old biddies, Jazz. They come here to help us.
That's my point, Caroline. They're gonna help us ride into heaven our own Wii without it.
You two got your parts down? I think so, but I don't know how I'm gonna cry. I'm not even sad, hurt, or nothing.
What? It's all that one.
Betsy, stop that! You two can't make a slide to those nice ladies. If you want a wee stump or whatever that is, you two can ask for yourselves. Besides, I don't want one of those for Christmas.
Oh yeah, we know. You're hoping to get out of Dodge for Christmas.
What does that mean?
You're hoping to bust out of here, aren't you?
Bust out? I don't want to bust out. I want a home for Christmas. I want someone to want me as their very own girl. I want to have my own mom in my very own bedroom. I want to grow up knowing that I'm the most special girl in the world to someone.
This is great. Keep going, girl. Get those tears flowing. Mrs. Lloyd is going to be down here any second. Chip can't remember his lines, but you can. Those tears are going to make it seem so convincing.
No, Betsy, I'm not going to do it, so leave me and Chip alone.
What's going on in here? You kids are supposed to be in your rooms making your beds.
Why, Caroline, what's wrong, honey?
Oh, Miss Lloyd, she's being sad.
Yeah, she's been crying all morning saying something about a wee.
That's all she's been talking about, Miss Lloyd. We've been down here to help her make you feel better.
A wee? What's a wee, Caroline? Tell me all about it, dear.
Yeah, tell her all about it, Caroline.
The same as always, it won't be me. Now, Caroline, I know how much you want to be someone's girl for Christmas, and I pray that it will happen for you soon. But while you're here, you have a home here in the orphanage with me and all the other orphans. We love you, don't we, Chip?
But Miss Lawton,
she's a girl. And while you're here, she's your sister. We can love sisters, can't we?
I guess so.
Come on, Caroline, church week is Thursday. We don't want to miss it.
That's okay, Chip. You go on ahead. I don't feel like watching sharks today.
Every day is a day for sharks, if you ask me.
Yoo-hoo, Lucia! Ah, there you are. My goodness, we about got tackled by a dozen kids running pell-mell past us.
They were shouting something about sharks. Oh, yes, it's Shark Week on TV. They all just love it.
TV? You allow the youngsters to watch TV? Isn't there something more valuable they could do in their time?
Well, it is their Christmas vacation. I like to loosen up the rules a bit during the holiday season.
Well, I guess so, but I still think they should be filling the time with things like music, reading, art, playing outdoors, things like that.
Oh, but Betty, Shark Week's really amazing. Well, you know, Charles and I watch it all the time.
Well, children turn into zombies when they sit in front of that TV, let me tell you.
And they get fat. I have enough of those forever staring at that too. Well, let's just say that he can stand to get up and get moving.
Send him to aerobics class, I say. But that is neither here nor there. Lucille, we are here to discuss the Christmas Annual Fun Fest. I trust you and the orphans have been preparing.
Yes, we have. And let me just say, I think this will be the best year yet.
Oh, I do enjoy the fun fest.
Me too, Viola. It's my favorite part of the holiday season. Remember last year when a group of kids just up like Christmas? Is going to be with you twice again for Christmas?
That was fun. And don't forget the grand finale.
The magic act, the fabulous Vandees. They actually made Stanley disappear.
And then he reappeared dressed like a nun to pass out the gifts. It was really entertaining.
Well, ladies, as much as I enjoy our little trip down memory lane, let's get to business at hand. So, Lucille, once again, the ladies has raised enough money for the Christmas extra expenses for the Christmas season.
Oh, Betty, you don't know how much this means to us here at God's Children Orphanage. There'd be no gifts for us, the children, without the Ladies Society. Thank you so much.
It's our pleasure, dear. The ladies are always willing to pitch in, and they are all looking forward to the Fun Fest as we turn in their investment.
Do we have any families interested in adopting this year?
Emmeline, that's your territory. Have you had any interested families acquiring?
Yes, I have Mr. and Mrs. Wainwright that have expressed interest in adopting a child this year. I believe that they are looking for a little girl.
I'm a little girl. What about me? I'm really well-behaved, and I'm smart.
I will never come back. I keep my room clean.
This is an adult conversation we're having, dear. You need to run along.
Could you tell Mr. and Mrs. Wainwright about me?
Could you tell them that I want a family this year for Christmas? Could you? Well, dear, I guess you have just as much as a chance of any other girls, but we must leave that decision on to the ranks.
Off we go!
My name is Caroline!
My, what a darling girl she is.
She doesn't know enough to stay out of adult conversations, though.
She is a good girl, but she desperately wants a home.
Poor child.
All right, Lucille, do you have the extra flyers for the Fun Fest? We want to finish handing them out around town today.
Well, they were here a minute ago.
I couldn't imagine what could have happened to them.
Well, you boys will be having extra chores this evening.
Okay, Mrs. Lawton.
Lucille, I think I know what happened to your extra Fun Fest flyers.
Dylan! You used my flyer for airplanes!
Well, it's
laugh a minute. I'll have my flyers made, and then I'll have Stanley bring them over to you.
Good old Stanley. He's the best handyman around. All right, dear, we must get going. Keep those kids practicing. We expect a good show next week. Let's go, girls.
Bye now.
Toodles.
Oh, dear.
Here, Lucille, let me help you with that. Let me guess, the boys thought they'd fly the flyers?
You guessed right, Stanley. I'll have my flyers made, and then would you bring them over to the Ladies' Society for me?
Sure.
Why so excited, Stanley? It wouldn't be because you want to see Mrs. Branson now, would it?
No, I'd just like to get out and get some fresh air. That's all. Here, let me take those for you.
Thank you, Stanley. Now, it sounds like those ladies are really expecting something big this year. I just hope we can deliver. What now?
Mrs. Long, don't quit! Chip put a toy shark in the toilet, and Dylan flushed it down, and now the toilet is overflowing everywhere. And Chip is crying about his shirt, and the other boys are starting to beat Dylan up because of what he did to Chip's shirt. Come quick!
Never, Donald.
Okay, guys, back to business. Go ahead, Benny.
And now, ladies
hear Gracie's stories.
Thank you.
So how did Chip get a shark back?
Well, you see, by the time the sun came, Dylan had started to feel sorry for Chip. He took his hand, stuck into a toy. His whole arm disappeared. He kept trying to convince him out about the shark. And then Dylan waved around all the girls' faces, and we were all screaming. And then Mrs. Zong comes in and goes, "What is going on?" And then throws the shark at Chip, and Mrs. Zong goes, "Give that shark to me." And it was all wet and dirty from the toilet. And then sent Dylan to his room for the rest of the night.
Wow, that's quite a story. Thanks for sharing that with me.
No problem. That's Betty Best.
So, how goes the new magic dance, boys? Are the fabulous Bandinis going to amaze the crowd again this year?
Well, trying to, Miss Callie, but if we keep interrupting like this, we'll never be ready.
This place is always crawling with people.
Yeah, too many people if you ask me.
Well, if you guys are still mad, Mom, why don't you make the people disappear?
That's a good idea, Gracie. We'll start by making you disappear.
No, but come with us. We'll be our most miraculous disappearance of all.
No, not me, Miss Callie!
Okay, guys, I don't think Gracie wants to disappear today.
Why don't we make part of her disappear?
And what part would that be?
Her mouth!
One of these days.
Oh, Miss Kelly,
I'm glad you're in the deal. We have a chance at the fun pass.
Great, that's why I'm here. What is the name of your act?
Beauty on Heels.
Okay, what exactly is Beauty on Heels?
Just what it says. We are the beauty and these are our heels.
Okay, what will you be doing on your heels?
Being beautiful, of course.
Alrighty then, sounds interesting. I'll put it down. Beauty on Heels by Alicia and Annabelle.
Come on, Alicia, we need to practice some more.
But I'm already beautiful.
But you're not so good on heels. Remember, stop licking and mean it.
Oh, Miss Callie, how fortunate that you've arrived. I have been just dying to tell you. My time for the show this year.
Alexandra, I'm so sure you have something just wonderful planned for the fun fest. Your one-woman play of Romeo and Juliet last year had the crowd on their feet. The way it changed from Romeo to Juliet was so clever.
Yes, that was pure magic, wasn't it? Would you like me to show you a little bit of that dazzling performance? Romeo, oh Romeo, wherefore art thou Romeo? It is the east, and Juliet is the south. Deny thy father, or refuse thy name, or if thou will not be but sworn, my love, and I will no longer be a Capulet. Did my heart not love till now? Forswear it, say, I not see beauty until this night.
That's so clever, Alexandra. I can't wait to be hearing what you're going to be doing this year.
I know. Everyone is just dying to see me perform on stage. That is where I should have rung you. My name in lights on Broadway.
Let's just concentrate on this performance right now. Can you tell me the name of your act?
That is the problem, Miss Callie, but there are so many things I can do. I just can't decide which one.
Well, we're running out of time, Alexandra. I need to make the programs, and I need to write your act.
Just this. A dazzling performance by Alexandra Starr! That should describe well enough.
Okay, a dazzling
performance.
Performance by Alexandra.
Alexandra Starr. Don't forget the star part. And the star is with two R's.
Got it, I can't wait.
I know, Miss Kelly, I know. But believe me, it will be worth the wait. Au revoir! I saw her first. Mrs. Long told me to show her around. Right, Marie?
Right.
But you like us better, don't you, Marie?
Well...
Don't let them bully you, Marie. You just speak up. Do you want me and Caroline to show you around your new home, or do you want Jen and Betsy to show you around?
I don't know.
Sure you do, Marie. Me and Jen know more about this place, because you see, we've been here longer. Right, Jess?
Yeah, we've been here longer than you. So don't let them mean you know everything.
You two just learn how to read yourself so you can boss her around yourself. Marie,
don't listen.
Come on, Anna.
Back off. Marie is ours. Come on, Marie.
Whoa, girls. Marie, it looks like you're going to have a lot of friends. I'm Miss Kelly.
I help take care of the kids here at the orphanage. Nice to meet you.
Nice to meet you, too.
Miss Kelly, I've been waiting to talk to you all day.
What about Caroline?
Well, I'd like to talk to you in private, please.
No problem. But first, let me ask the girls something. Girls? Mrs. Lund has put me in charge of the fun fest, and I need to know what you will be doing so I can make the program.
We're dancing.
Dancing? What kind of dancing?
Cool dancing.
Okay, to what music will you be dancing?
Christmas music.
Cool Christmas music.
This one's down for Daddy and the rest of the day. Dancing at Christmas music.
Cool Christmas music.
Got it.
And Marie and I will be reciting a Christmas poem.
I will.
Don't worry, Marie. I'll teach you everything you need to know. It'll be great. Just leave it to me, honey.
Okay.
Christmas poetry. Sounds great.
Marie, if you don't want to recite poetry, you can always come dance with us.
Yeah, it's gonna be a lot cooler than poetry.
No, it's okay. I'll be fine with Eve.
Good girl. We better go fast. Let's go, girl.
We got some things to get out. Later.
Caroline. We're alone now. What is it you wanted to talk to me about?
It's about the Fun Fest.
Yes, and what will you be doing?
I won't be doing anything.
Why not?
It's too scary. Having all those people staring at you, wondering if any of them would want to adopt a girl like me. I get stage fright, and nothing comes out of my mouth at all. Not one single peep.
But you love to sing, Caroline. I've heard you. You have a lovely voice.
But not in front of lots of people. And the worst part is, I want a family for Christmas. And if I don't perform, I won't be noticed. And I so want to be noticed, Miss Callie. I so want a home of my own, but I don't think it's ever going to happen. I'll never be anyone's girl.
Oh, but Caroline, you already are someone's girl.
I am?
Remember last Easter Sunday when you accepted Jesus as your Savior?
How could I forget that? It was the best day of my life.
I know. When you accepted Jesus as your Savior, you're adopted into God's family. You're a daughter of the King, Caroline. You're a princess. It doesn't get much better than that.
A part of God's family? A daughter of the King? A princess?
I never thought about it like that. It's pretty wonderful, isn't it? God loves you so much, Caroline. You're His girl.
I'm glad I'm His girl. I really am, Miss Kelly.
But would it be alright if I was someone else's girl, too?
Of course it would, Caroline. Family's our gift. I understand you want a family of your own. Who knows? This could be the Christmas. Now let's get you signed up for an act, shall we?
I guess I could try. Maybe sing Silent Night?
Sounds great. Now you run along and start practicing. And don't forget, Caroline, you do belong. You belong to Jesus.
Thanks, Miss Callie.
If I ever get a mommy, I hope she's just like you. And if I ever get a little girl, Caroline, I hope she's just like you.
See if I I can convince the Mr. and Mrs. to see if they have room in their hearts for our precious little Dylan.
Why, here they are now. Welcome. Welcome. John, Mary, I'd like you to meet Lucille Lawton. Lucille, this is John and Mary. Lucille runs Scouts to the Northpointe.
Nice to meet you, Lucille. Betty has told us so much about you and the Northpointe. We are very excited about having a child of our own.
And our children are just wonderful. You would be blessed to have any one of them.
And I have the one just for you, Mrs. Wainwright.
Oh, please, come to Mary.
Mary, you see, all the children here are quite adorable, but there's one that will just brighten up the Wainwright home.
Really? Why don't you tell me a bit about this child?
You see, he's a bright boy, as smart as they come. He's smart enough to be a pilot. Yeah, flying planes is right up his alley.
We could fly around the world with someone like that, Mary.
Oh, yes, we could. And I heard he's good with fish, too. Sharks in particular. He has the makings of a marine biologist.
Oh, we love those. See, Rob, don't jump. Yeah, we do, Mary.
And
now, Stanley, why don't you go finish setting up preparations for the reception following the show?
I've got everything done, Steele.
Now, Stanley.
Right away.
Betty, is there anything I can do for you before I go?
I don't think so, Stanley, but thank you.
At your service, ma'am.
John, Mary, are you two looking to adopt soon?
As soon as possible, Mrs. Lawton. We would like to spend Christmas with their child.
So soon?
Yes. All their paperwork is finished, and now they are just looking for the right child
to fit their family.
Will all the children be prepared tonight?
Most of them will. We have a few boys that have a bit of secret, but I'm hoping they'll join the kids for the finale.
Oh, good. I can
remember that. Mrs. Wainwright, can I ask you something?
Of course.
Are you looking to adopt a boy or a girl?
Well, John, of course, looks like a boy. But I have my heart set on a sweet girl, blonde and frightened, like me, and small, a young girl with a sweetheart. What's wrong, dear? Do you know any small other small girls here at the orphanage?
Yes, we do. But
what?
Mrs. Vaughn, Mrs. Vaughn, come quick. You've got to stop him.
Calm down, Gracie. Can't you see we have gas?
Well, of course I can see we have guests. That's why this is so bad. Jump through Chip out the window.
What?
Whatever do you mean?
Well, the fabulous Bundinis were practicing their disappearing act, and Dylan goes, that's nothing. I can make Chip disappear right now. And Betty goes, how do you do that? And Dylan goes, just watch me. And he picks up Chip and they're right out the window. Everyone is screaming, especially Chip. And luckily it was on the first floor, because if it would have been upstairs, Chip would have been a goner.
Well, Dylan is going to be a goner when I get a hold of him. Callie, will you take over for me what I would do with Dylan?
Of course, Mrs. Lawton.
Dylan,
the one
that your handyman Stanley signed me about the bright young pilot marine biologist.
I'm afraid so.
I don't think we're quite crazy to chat with that. Let's scratch him off our list here. There will be no chat with him.
No worries now. There are plenty more adorable children to choose from. While the show is about to begin, shall we get to our seats?
That sounds like a great idea. Betty, can you get our guests settled? I should go check on the kids and make sure they're all ready for the show to begin.
Absolutely. You two come with me. We'll give you two a nice front row seat.
Just
sit,
John. In a few moments, we can meet the child we've always dreamed of. Let's just hope for now, like the Dylan character. What about that girl? She was so sweet. I don't think so, dear. I'm too, we're not used to so much babbling. Perhaps, but she was so cute. I'm excited. That's cool. Sit back here and enjoy the show. I have a feeling we'll know the child when we see him. Okay. Yes, dear, or her. Not the role of the mouth, please. We could talk about paint on the side of the house that one could.
Are you too comfortable?
Yes, quite.
I'm so excited.
Let the show begin.
Good evening, everyone. On behalf of God's
children, orphanage, I would like to welcome you to our annual Christmas piano show. I would like to welcome the Ladies Society, who is so much here to make our children have a special Christmas each and every year. Thank you, ladies. The children have been working hard to make this a night for you to remember. So sit back and enjoy as our children try our best to entertain each and every one of you. Please welcome our first act, Eve, Marie, and Gracie, reciting an old Christmas favorite, "'Twas the Night Before Christmas."
Just fun. Now the jingle bell has begun.
Jason, Jasper, me. And here's my puppet Jason. Say hello, people, Jason.
Hello, everyone. Merry Christmas to you. Hey, Jasper. What do you call an old snowman?
What do you call an old snowman?
Water.
Pretty funny.
I know. Hey, Jasper, what do snowmen eat for breakfast?
What do snowmen eat for breakfast?
Frosty Flakes. Get it? Frosty Flakes?
I got them for you, Jason. What do you think it costs a snowman and a vampire?
I don't know.
Frostbite.
Good one. All right, I got one for you. Hey, Jasper, how does snowmen lose weight?
How?
They wait for the weather to get warmer.
Here's the best one.
Why is it the best one?
So I'm funnier than you. You're just a puppet. You just say what I make you say.
Oh, yeah? Yeah. You're not talking for me now, are you, big guy? Well, now you're not... You're not talking for me now, are you, big guy? Yeah, see? This snowman puppet's got a mouth of its own. How you like that?
Oh, that's me, huh? Fat outlaw puppet?
This is just my costume. Plus, it's better than both of them.
Performing an all-time favorite, Let It Snow.
not. In fact, I'm spending before much more than a rabbit out of a hat. It's Christmas, after all, a time for great surprises.
So watch closely. Don't blink, or you'll miss it.
But wait, we need our fabulous assistant for this trick, don't we? Every magic act needs a lovely assistant. Where's our beautiful assistant?
Oh, beautiful assistant! Please appear, we need you!
Come out, dear assistant!
Come here, beautiful assistant! Trying to make a run for it!
Hey! Come now, beautiful assistant!
Do I have to?
Of course, we have help with our hat trick.
Isn't the hat trick something you do in hockey?
Yeah, today. Folks, meet our lovely assistant, Galania.
Ta-da!
day of Christmas my true love gave to me.
Five extra chores!
One on the bong bong.
Four fluffy scarves.
Three magic tricks. Two shiny high-ups.
And a check so that we can buy a Wii.
On the sixth day of Christmas my true love gave to me.
Six blocks to play with.
Sure, people won't be the same without you.
Yeah, Chip. We always sit on the big blue beanbag in Shark Week. We eat our popcorn, tons of butts with cheesy flavors. Then afterwards, we choose our favorite shark and pretend to be those sharks and fight to the death.
Terry!
You can shark!
Time to go, Chip. Have you said all your goodbyes?
I think so. Bye, everyone.
Bye!
Let's go, Chip. The nurse are anxiously waiting for you. The rest of you, clean your room. But when I return, we'll open Christmas presents! Yeah!
Though I don't see what's so merry about it. Chip is gone, and so is another chance for me to have a real home.
Oh, honey, I know you'll miss him. He was a good friend. But don't be so sure you won't have another chance to have a real home.
But next Christmas is a whole year away. I don't want to wait that long for a family.
Who says you have to wait over another year?
Well, that's usually when the rich folks come to adopt us.
Well, what if someone else wants to adopt you?
Like who?
Like, me?
What?
Caroline, I've been working at the orphanage for over 2 years now. I've spent almost every day with you, Caroline. I've grown to love you. I love you like you're my girl.
You do?
I do. And I've been working with Mrs. Blunt, doing all the paperwork in order so that I can adopt you.
You really want me for your very own? You would be my mom?
If you want me to be.
But where will I live?
At my house. But since I work here, you can still visit the kids here at the orphanage all the time.
But at the end of the day, I get to come home with you, right?
Yes, you come home with me.
For always?
Forever and always.
Oh, Miss Kelly, I love you. Thank you for knowing me for your very own girl. Now, I'm part of two families.
Two?
Yes, your family and Dad's family.
That makes it a pretty good Christmas, huh?
The best Christmas ever.
Mom, quick, Miss Kelly. Look, Dylan's opening up all the presents, and he said he didn't want to wait for Mrs. Vaughn. And since he's the oldest, he should be in charge. And all the little kids are crying because they won't be able to open the presents. And Dylan's laughing all mean like the Grinch stole Christmas. Come on, Callie, you've got to come.
Well, we better go stop Dylan the Grinch.
Yeah, let's go, Miss Callie. Wait, can I call you Mom?
Yeah, you better. Now let's go before he opens all the presents.
Coming! Mom!